After a horror political run, the last thing the Premier needs is a factional divide, but that's exactly what he's getting as Liberals jostle for the deputy leadership. A vote to fill the position left vacant by Stuart Ayres is still days away, and as chaos reigns, there's only one winner.
The Labor leader's trying not to get ahead of himself.
I don't take anything for granted.
But Chris Minns has a shopping list of reasons to smile.
Political scandals involving Ward, Sidoti, Ayres, Barilaro and Patinos.
It's been a bruising few months for the Perrottet government. One former minister charged with sexual violence, another found corrupt by ICAC, one sacked for bullying, and yesterday the most senior scalp. Trade Minister Stuart Ayres forced to resign over his role in the John Barilaro job saga. All four deny any wrongdoing, but all have undeniably damaged the coalition's brand.
When politicians are talking about themselves, that's the worst thing that could be happening.
But the navel-gazing isn't over yet. The departure of Stuart Ayres triggers a party room vote here on Tuesday to elect a new deputy Liberal leader, and unsurprisingly, a split has emerged in the ranks.
The obvious candidate, Treasurer Matt Keane, went to ground today as factional rival David Elliott threw his hat in the ring.
Matt Keane has as many qualities as I have. The question for the parliamentary Liberal Party is what qualities do they want to prioritise?
While one-time leadership contender Rob Stokes wants the party to pick a woman.
Some really talented, capable women. I think their voice should be heard.
And some have just seen one too many party room ballots.
Do you have a preference over who ends up deputy?
I'm voting for you. Thank you very much. Bye.
Liz Daniels, Nine News.
Good evening. Matthew Guy says demands for his resignation are ridiculous as the ghosts of a former scandal come back to haunt the Liberal leader. He's adamant his chief of staff didn't actually do anything wrong, but rank-and-file MPs aren't underestimating the optics. Stephanie Anderson with the latest.
Union-backed and keen to boil up some drama, these lobsters, flanked by a former health minister, were a spectacle on the steps of state parliament. But out the back, it was the opposition leader in the pressure cooker.
No. That's just conspiracy. Yes means yes.
Matthew Guy again facing questions over his chief of staff's conduct. Mitch Catlin quit his powerful role, yet the Liberals are adamant nothing dicey happened.
Mitch stood down because we want to maintain the perceptions are right, that there is nothing that could be incorrect. Even though nothing was signed, nothing was agreed.
But an email outlining a proposed deal designed to solicit payments from party donors for Catlin's private business was sent. Even the leader doesn't dispute that.
Did it not raise any alarm bells for you when that dropped into your Hotmail email?
The fact that nothing occurred says everything.
Victorians have a right to know.
The state government has called far and wide for an investigation. IBAC today confirming it's received the complaint.
I can't run a running commentary on a matter that they have sent off to every investigative body in this state by the AFL Tribunal.
And that's the same no-comment position Labor's employed amid probes of the past.
I will not be lectured by this government on integrity matters.
You're comfortable there's not a double standard being set here on integrity?
Well, I don't see it that way at all, no.
It's very much the whatever it takes attitude to politics these days. I think so many people are just over it.
Victorians will have their say in 114 days, and one ousted Liberal says it's time for the coalition to make a change.
They are driving toward a cliff in the dark, unless they stop that car and get a new driver, they're all going to die.
This is ridiculous.
Stephanie Anderson joins us now. Steph, this scandal is rippling through the Liberal ranks.
It certainly is, Pete. Today I've confirmed some party members have slowed down or postponed some of their election campaigning to try and create a bit of distance from this scandal. There's definitely a sense that the impact on the Liberals' reputation shouldn't be underestimated, particularly this close to an election and on such a hot-button topic as integrity. As for the role of Chief of Staff in Matthew Guy's office, today the leader confirmed he will be filling it very soon. Who takes on that position? Well, Pete, that is a case of watch this space.